What's the most critical process in your organization? What happens if this process stops working? What are you willing to give up to prevent that damage from happening? Hi, this is Carsten from Hacking Matters, where each week we compare the trade-offs in cybersecurity. Today we dive deeper into the age-old question of how much security is enough, and at what point does security become a burden rather than a boon for companies. Lots has been discussed and written on the question of how much security is enough, and the topic might feel very complex because of all of that prior discussion. But I think that a lot of this discussion is misguided, making the topic look difficult, where really it is relatively simple, and we just have to face the reality that security isn't always the most important thing. But sometimes it is, and distinguishing these situations is exactly what security professionals are there for. Let me tap your expertise here as well by bringing you on a small journey we go through together. Start with the first question. What's the most critical process in your organization? The process that is your core business, your core brand, the identity of the company that shouldn't stop. Give it a moment to think about it. And I'll assume that the process you wrote down is an IT-enabled process. Almost all of them are today. But of course, we're talking about cybersecurity. So if you happen to be in a company that has some processes still that are not IT enabled, go choose another one. So everyone chose an IT enabled process that is critical to your business. Second question, what happens if this process stops working for 2 minutes, 2 days, or 2 weeks? Pause here to think about it for a moment. What happens to your business, to your customer relationships, to your internal organization if your process stops for 2 minutes, 2 days, or 2 weeks? Most of you will have concluded that if the process stops for 2 minutes, you can cope. There's probably IT systems that automatically catch up, but at the very least, the amount of damage is very controlled. No need to panic. You will also have concluded that if the process stopped for 2 weeks, you're in serious trouble. Basically, this is a must not happen scenario where all of your business continuity management is set up to prevent exactly that. That leaves the middle path, the 2 day downtime, where most of you would have concluded that this is a serious damage to your company, but not the end of anything. You can recover, and it might take some time, it might cost a lot of money, but you can survive. And it is that scenario that we're most concerned with in cybersecurity. The 2 minute scenario, we write off as normal process exceptions. The processes themselves need to be built a little bit resilient. The 2 week scenario, we hand over to BCM, backup and recovery, basically making sure that we can rebuild the entire process within a few days so that we would never reach that 2 day point. But in a cyber attack, we're seriously looking at a 2 day downtime before you could have responded, before you could have recovered. And now the question becomes, how painful is this to your company, the cyber attack ramification? You already wrote down your answer, or at least your intuition, so you know the damage. Now let's look at the other side of the equation. What are you willing to give up to prevent that damage from happening? In an insecure company, let's say your processes would be down for 2 days every single quarter, you'd be reoccurring. In that scenario, you can introduce security controls to make the downtime less and less likely. People would be breaking in less often, less DDoS, less ransomware, just less negative impact of hacking. Each control you're introducing has costs attached to it. Some of the cost is borne by you as a security professional through your budgets, but most of the cost is actually borne by people who run the processes, whose process is now getting more complicated, it's getting slower, and it's getting less flexible. Let's talk through these in turn. If the process is becoming more complicated, you might actually have thrown the baby out with the bathwater because a more complex process is more prone to fail. Security controls fail all the time, sometimes taking down, for instance, an entire IT network. We've seen a CrowdStrike incident. So one effect of you trying to prevent downtime through hacking could be to introduce downtime through failing security controls. So complex processes are costly for organizations in many ways. Equally, a slower process is costly to your organization in many ways. Your customers might not have the same experience. You might lose business. It's death by a thousand cuts if you prune and prune and prune your processes to mostly be secure, but not anything else anymore. Finally, and most importantly, the inflexibility of a process can be a real poison pill. And security controls make your process less flexible. They're overburdening it with new rules, with new constraints to make it more secure. But that also means the process is less easy to adapt to new business requirements. And so slowly you're falling behind in the market if somebody else has more agile processes, more agile understanding and use of technology, where they just move past you. So that in a somewhat ironic situation, you might be protecting your customers very well on your systems, but those customers choose to go to a less secure company because they just have more attractive products. So between all of these, your more complex, slower, less flexible processes, develop an intuition. How much would your business be willing to slow themselves down, constrain themselves, and so forth? Write down your answer. Now, this would be an estimate. It would be a range. But now start comparing the order of magnitude of this to the answer to the previous question of how much the two-day downtime would cost. And if you notice that the cost that you're adding into your processes through your security controls outweigh the damage of the hacking incident, then perhaps we have gone beyond the goal. We have implemented more security than actually needed, and there's time for recalibration. And the recalibration doesn't need to be less security, but more agile security. Often you can replace one security control with an equally effective but slightly more expensive security control that doesn't stand in the way of people as much. As a simple example, if right now you have a heavy regime of network segregation where nobody is allowed to speak to anyone else unless they fill out a lot of paperwork, imagine replacing this regime with strict security monitoring, where everyone can speak with everyone else, but it's being looked at. And if there is abuse, that abuse is being uncovered and hackers are eventually being found out. Now, in some scenarios, this is actually more secure because even in a well-configured firewalled environment, hackers always find some sneaky ways around those. It takes a little bit of time. Whereas in a heavily monitored scenario, hackers don't know whether you're already onto them or not, so they might navigate a lot more carefully, constraining themselves. Either way, we can all agree that the permissionless environment where you're being monitored rather than constrained is a lot more innovation friendly. It does enable experimentation. It allows people to tinker with technology, even if that comes at the risk of sometimes being less secure. And that's where you as the security professional come in as the advisor to help them make informed choices as they're doing experiments rather than trying to prevent those experiments in the first place. So hopefully this little exercise in choosing your most critical process, figuring out how much a two-day downtime would cost you, and figuring out how much you trying to prevent a two-day downtime is allowed to cost, hopefully less than what you're trying to prevent, to have an overall uplift. Hopefully that was helpful. If you have questions or comments, we'd love to read them below. And if you enjoyed this video, like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time. Happy hacking.